Hey guys, how's it going? Chez back again, and welcome to episode number 16 of the Chelsea Career Mode here on FIFA 15. We came out of transfer deadline day yesterday, so we have acquired a couple of new players. If you missed yesterday's episode, then definitely check it out before you watch this one if you don't want to avoid, or if you do want to avoid any spoilers as to who the new players are. But team news.
Quite a few changes for Aston Villa. Brad Guzan plays in goal. Matthew Lotan replaces Ali Sissoko, who's been out of sorts lately. Gary Gardner plays with Fabian Delph in the centre of the park. In attack, Andy Vyman partners up top with Christian Benteke. Here's the Chelsea lineup. Thibaut Courtois starts in goal. Gary Cahill starts with Aymeric Laporte as the centre-backs. Eden Hazard starts with Lucas on the flanks. Diego Costa is the lone striker today.
So then, Aston Villa away in the snow. Definitely not the easiest of fixes by any means. And actually, Aston Villa away has been a fixture in which Chelsea have actually fallen foul to a few horrible results in the past few seasons. Most notably, the one a couple of years ago where we conceded two very late goals to, in fact, lose the game. I think it was 3-2. Or even they came back from 3-1 down to equalise 3-3. I genuinely can't remember. All I know is I hate going away to Villa Park. But we're playing in the snow in this one. We've had a couple of chances already. This one is coming down the right hand side through Fabregas and Lucas, of course, our new player. Eden Hazard with a decent chance that really should have put away, actually, was perhaps trying to aim for that near post, but he didn't quite get the connection he wanted to. Kind of hit it too centrally for my liking, but still, we head into the second half now. It was a game of few chances, at least in the first half, as both sides were really trying to get to grips with the conditions. But Fabian Delph squares the ball across to Benteke here, and I just have no idea why Courtois twice has done that stumble celebration, or just kind of stab your foot at it and then just watch the ball animation. He's just done it twice. First one there is understandable, but to then do the exact same animation again is particularly infuriating, and I guess it's just part and parcel of these new goalkeepers for FIFA. They don't really seem to do too much when it comes to close range stuff like that, but they had a goalkeeper on form themselves, Brad Guzan, down well to parry away that deflected shot from the Manu Matic. And it was a case of throwing bodies forward now, switching to attacking or ultra-attacking, and just trying to get ourselves back in the game, because a defeat is definitely not what we need right now. Shot that was actually heading on target from Diego Costa, as you'll see from the replay initially, and then bent away as he kind of struck across it with the angle that he was running at, kind of rather unlucky that it bent away so much, otherwise it would have been rather a spectacular goal. But Benteke is trying to stand the ball up here. We get it away initially with Laporte, and it only drops as far as Gary Gardner, and then he actually gets it back from a deflection, and we're lucky there that fell to Nzogbia's right foot and not his left. Otherwise, I have a funny feeling we may have found ourselves 2-0 down, but we're still on the attack ourselves, as you saw. We're trying to get ourselves back in it, but unfortunately leaving a few gaps at the back, which they tried to exploit, but Brad Guzan again not really holding on to the effort, parrying it away. But we get a free kick right at the very death of the game in stoppage time now. Andre Schürrle is going to stand it up, and new signing Ross Barkley powers home the header. He comes to the rescue. Is Ross to the rescue, you might say. Ross Barkley comes onto the pitch to be our saviour with a last minute header to equalise, and we steal a point away from Aston Villa, although I guess it's not really stealing a point because we definitely had enough chances to win the game. But Brad Guzan and his defence will definitely be disappointed that they weren't able to hold on until the very end and keep their clean sheet and all 3 points. But I'm quite happy that Ross Barkley's had an immediate impact. He scored a goal on his debut, in fact a very good goal on his debut yesterday for us against Huddersfield in the FA Cup, and now he scored a header in his second game against Aston Villa. And the third game we have that he's going to be involved in is against his former side, Everton. As you can see, they're 11th, we are 3rd, 2 points behind Man City with a game in hand. Hopefully we can pick up a win to close that gap. Here's your team news.
Here's the Chelsea lineup. Thibaut Courtois starts in goal. Ricardo Rodriguez starts with Branislav Ivanovic in the fullback positions. André Schürrle starts with Eden Hazard on the flanks. In attack, Diego Costa starts. He's been in tremendous form recently. Quite a few changes for Everton. Tim Howard starts in goal. Ashley Williams replaces Sylvain Distant, who's been out of sorts lately. James McCarthy plays with Gareth Barry in the centre of the park. In attack, Romelu Lukaku starts, replacing Samuel Eto'o, who's injured.
So Romelu Lukaku facing his former club, as is Ross Barkley. I kind of felt it apt to start him, regardless of the fact he was against Everton, considering he came to the rescue at the end of the previous game. So Ross starts, unfortunately Lucas drops to the bench, and we actually had to rely on our own goalkeeper here, Thibaut Courtois, much like Villa were relying on Guzan in the previous game. Courtois gets down well to make a good save. But Eden Hazard with a good roll away there to get the ball into Fabregas eventually. It's going to a nice turn actually by the Spaniard. Gets the shot away, deflecting. That really could have gone anywhere. I was hoping that was going to loop into the top corner. Unfortunately, it didn't. And then Seamus Coleman fouled Diego Costa there. Clearly a foul, and Seamus Coleman is going to get booked. Then the game kind of glitched out. You'll be able to see in just a second. It just went back to this screen. The clock has sped up as if the game was actually playing at normal rate, and Seamus Coleman and the referee proceeded to just walk into each other. And the only way I could get it to actually fix itself was to make a substitution. So unfortunately, Cesc came off in the 26th minute for William Carvalho, who was making his first appearance for quite a while for the club. I've actually kind of gone off William Carvalho a little bit, to be completely honest. I really get on with Matic in that holding role as kind of the big lump player, so to speak, to go alongside Cesc. And actually, Junior Malanda is my favourite of the two between he and William Carvalho. But in fact, it was Romelu Lukaku, another Belgian, speaking of Junior Malanda, that unfortunately puts us 1-0 down, scoring against his former club. So maybe Ross Barkley could do the same for us against Everton on the other side of things. But Diego Costa not really having too much of an impact at this stage in the game, but he's going to turn inside beautifully here, inside Phil Jagielka. And actually, it's a really nice finish with the outside of his right foot to get it underneath the goalkeeper into the far bottom corner. And we bounce back immediately, just 2 or 3 minutes after they go 1-0 in front. We're back on level terms. And who's the man straight across to celebrate with his new teammate? Ross Barkley. So you get the feeling if he does score, he won't be doing the apology celebration. But Christian Atsu, a player that's on loan from us at Everton, comes very close there to getting them back in front, as he did in the other game, the earlier game we played against Everton at Goodison Park. Christian Atsu came close to giving them a goal, and actually Leighton Baines is working the magic here, and Lukaku somehow onside thanks to Ricardo Rodriguez's ability to not keep up with the defensive line. But fortunately for us, Romelu misses the target and we stay at 1-1. Made a couple of changes. Barkley coming off for Oscar, and then Hazard for Willian as well, to add a little bit of more Brazilian flair perhaps to the starting, well, not to the starting lineup, but to the current in-game lineup. Oscar, as you can see on the ball, working the ball around well, gets caught on it by Barry. Not a foul though. He must have got something on the ball, but Diego Costa links up with Oscar again. Good shot, and that is only a whisker over the top of the bar. We came very close to taking a 2-1 lead there. Willian involved as well. Both players came onto the pitch and had a real positive influence, which was particularly pleasing. But Willian sets at Matic and a way to hit that first time, and he just took that extra touch which let the defender come across and get his foot in and stop us from being able to get the shot away quicker and really causing the goalkeeper some problems. But Andres Schell is going to find Diego Costa with a lovely dinked ball over the top. Two defenders on him though, so he didn't really have the angle to try and find any part of the goal. And unfortunately for us, Tim Howard was on form to palm that one away, and he found a defender, not a striker, so we can't even get the rebound, and we get another 1-1 draw. So it's two games back-to-back with a 1-1 draw, and I was getting rather frustrated, so I thought I'd give you a squad report rather than playing a third game, because we've got a couple of big ones in tomorrow's episode, most notably Manchester City in the Premier League and Real Madrid in the Champions League. So two huge games coming in tomorrow's episode, so make sure you don't miss out on that by hitting the subscribe button if you're not subbed already, or of course you can check the schedule in the description. That will let you know exactly what and when you can expect videos from me. Two videos a day, every day of the week, 14 videos a week, and we're having a squad report in the background. Of course, as always with squad reports, if you want to pause it at any point of the video to have a closer look at any player's individual stats, then feel free to do so. As you can see, Lucas into the club on already making progress. I'm quite weirded out by the fact that Diego Costa's physical stats are starting to drop. That's rather unrealistic. It may have something to do with the fact that he had that injury that kept him out for 3 months with a broken ankle. So maybe I'm reading too much into it. Maybe they'll start to go back up now that he's started to get back into the first team and he's scoring goals as well. A couple of players, youth players, that don't necessarily get a lot of first team football, like Nathan Ake, are actually improving quite nicely. So it must be just part of their growth curve to do so despite not playing too much football. Kurt Zouma actually has had a decent amount of football, and is growing nicely as well. Ross Barkley fresh into the club, £6.5 million apparently his value, despite the fact that we paid 20.5 for him. But you have to pay for English players, especially the ones that show the most promise. And Ricardo Rodriguez really improving well across the board, as is Andre Schürrle on the technical side of things, so pleased with that. A lot of players actually growing quite nicely so far, so things are looking up for us when it comes to the future of the series. Of course, we'll be doing at least two seasons here, if not three, before we start one elsewhere. We've also got the Atletico Madrid career mode series running as well, an episode of which went up last night, so check the channel page for that if you missed it. Junior Melander as well, as you can see, a young player going up nicely in rating. And we'll have a My Player episode later on tonight as well, so be sure to check your sub boxes for that around about 8 o'clock. Some of the loan players actually are going up quite nicely as well. Torres up 2 to 83 despite now being over 30 years of age. Marco Marin up 2 as well. Ruben Loftus-Cheek has actually shown a little upturn in ability since going out on loan to Wickham. And Marco van Ginkel and Lucas Piazza are players that I hopefully will be able to filter into the first team starting next season, although Lucas Piazza may go out on loan for one more year. Christian Atsu is probably the player I will sell on, because we've brought in Lucas and he is much more of an all-round player for that wide role, so he'll be the one that stays. Atsu probably going to move on, and some of the youngsters, as you can see, out on loan this year, and again I'll probably try to move those on next year rather than just giving them loan spells, or because they're not going to get any first team football with me here at Chelsea, but maybe, you know, I'll send them out on loan for one more year just to see if anyone shoots up in rating. But as you can see in the league table, everyone is on 24 games now, apart from a couple further down the league. But we are currently third, a point behind Manchester City and six behind Spurs, who rather surprisingly top the table after 24 rounds of fixtures. So 14 games left to try and get ourselves back up towards the top of the table. The minimum requirement was the title win, but well, we'll see what happens. We should be able to win it if we can put together a decent run of form, but I'm going to have to pull my finger out to close that gap to Spurs, considering we've played them twice already. So we really need them to drop points if we stand a chance of winning the title. But Champions League is most definitely on, and nailed on, I would have thought, for Champions League spot ourselves. But we'll try and win the title if we possibly can. If not, we'll do what Jose did and we'll give it a good old go in the second season after having a decent first season at the club. So that's going to bring today's episode to a close, guys. Thank you very much for watching. Drop the video a like if you enjoyed. If we could hit over 300 again, that would be absolutely superb. And like I say, sub if you haven't already. Links on screen and in the description and your normal subscription button to do so if you so desire. We're closing in on 27,000 subscribers now, which is absolutely epic. The support on the channel continues to go at a consistent rate, so I can't thank you enough for that. And like I say, show this video some love if you enjoyed it. But that's all from me for this afternoon. My Player later on tonight, so I will see you next time.